right, guys, well, here we are. It's a very bittersweet day. We're gonna take the good old ZX14 out for her last ride before put it up for sale. It's kind of weird, you know. I really like the bike. I've had it for like about 5 years now and had so much fun, but it's time to move on. So we got the caddy out of the way so we can pull the bike out. And we're gonna get some GoPro attachments. Got one for my chest and then got one for the side of the bike. And we'll get that all set up, have some good shots hopefully for the ride and make some memories. So let's do this. Hope you enjoyed my little ride through my backyard twisties. That road's great, except there's a lot of blind corners, a lot of dips that'll upset the bike, so you don't want to be going too fast and relying on the force on the friction of the tires on the road, because you'll go light in just a second and lose traction. Also, it's rained a lot here recently, and so as you probably saw, there's a lot of glistening portions or places where mud was, and I don't need any of that. So here we are at one of my favorite spots to view San Francisco Bay. I definitely like to come up here. Enjoy the view, especially on a clear day like this. This is awesome. I don't mind having a house up here either. But even these old houses from the, I'd say the early 80s or late 70s are worth about maybe 1.2 million up here. It's crazy.
This is actually my second bike. My first bike was a 2009 Suzuki GSXR 600. Probably not the best first bike. A lot of people be like, oh no, first bike, don't get a Gixxer. A lot of people do that, they get killed, whatever. Totally possible, idiots do. But I'm a little on the smarter side and responsible. And so yeah, I took it easy and I learned to ride the bike. It was great. You know, but it is a race bike and you really wrap yourself around that bike and brakes are touchy and it's fast, but I did okay. Now, the only thing I didn't like though is I started wanting to go places on the motorcycle and the Chixxer just wasn't comfortable. I mean, my legs hurt, my back hurt. My buddy Todd, he has a beautiful Monster Edition ZX14 and he's always talked about how comfortable it was. So I eventually sold the Chixxer, I moved to California, and in 2014, I think it is, I bought this bike. You know, I wanted this because I wanted to have a performance bike, have it more comfortable, and not sacrifice the performance, really. I mean, obviously, it doesn't handle quite as well as a 600, but it's definitely got more power than the 600. On the 600, I could totally go full throttle and it wouldn't lift the wheel. I mean, you really have to attempt to make a wheelie happen on that bike. This bike, you can be cruising on the freeway and in third gear, get on it and the wheel will just come up from, you know, the torque. It's pretty amazing. Here we are at one of my favorite spots in Oakland. It's the Blue Bottle Cafe, Broadway. Used to be an old truck dealership. It turned into a really nice cafe, so let's go have some coffee. I'll get one of those and one single origin cappuccino, please.
Okay. Did you want this right here? Do you want to
take it? Right here. Always tip your barista. That lamp over there. You know, people ask me, oh, what do you ride? And I was like, oh, well, a ZX14. And they go, oh, a big boy bike. I hear that answer a lot. And honestly, it kind of bugs me. Because, yeah, it's got a big motor, true. It's like 1350 cc's approximately. And it has lots of horsepower and torque. In 2006, this bike was the fastest thing you could buy off a showroom floor, car or bike. Amazing. But you know, the big boy bike concept, it's not the bike, dude, it's the rider. And honestly, I'm not a big boy rider, as in, I treat this thing with respect. I take it easy. I don't hit the curves super hard because I'm not super experienced. I'll open the throttle up when there's not a lot of traffic and I know I can't hit anything. You know, a big boy bike can be just about any bike. It just depends on how you ride it. And plus, the throttle on this bike is so smooth compared to like a Chixxer 1000 I rode once. It was so twitchy, touchy. It was like ready to romp. This bike is like 1,000 horsepower Mercedes. Smooth, comfy, it's awesome. The Chixxer 1000 to me is more like a Ferrari, just ready to bite. So yeah, you know, the concept of big boy bike, I don't really like that term. The bike is as big as the rider, let's put it that way.
Whew, well, I'm back at the house and yeah, that was a good ride. Good ride, good coffee, enjoyed it. But kind of reaffirmed that I'm not gonna miss it too much, but maybe I'll be getting something else another time. So now it's time to just get it all cleaned up for the new owner. Let's make it happen.
All right, well, after a good ride like that, I like to gently wipe off the bike with a microfiber towel. And then I'm gonna go ahead and do this reload half mixed with water. It's a silica spray sealant by CarPro. I'm gonna put that over. It'll keep it repelling water and super slick surface. I just ceramic coated it last week, so it's time to do this anyway, so.
And with that concept of big boy bike,
I see it a lot in the car community, of course, but definitely in the motorcycle community. There's so many people that buy a bike like this for their ego. They want to have the biggest, baddest bike. And I'm not gonna lie, there's a part of my ego that likes that. I mean, it's pretty cool. Yeah, I owned that what was at one time the biggest, baddest bike there was, right? But that's not why I bought it. I bought it because it suited me. It was a touring bike, but still had performance. So lots of egos. But thankfully in the motorcycle world, there's also this other half of people that are super respectful of motorcycles. They understand exactly why they are so dangerous. They understand, you know, what it takes to be a good, safe rider and not to be an idiot. And they're the ones that don't like the other group, because the other group makes motorcycle riders look bad. That kind of brings me to, you know, why do we ride? And when I started riding a motorcycle, I was really surprised to find out how meditative it is when you ride a motorcycle. I mean, because if you want to do it safely, you need to be focused. You need to focus your brain. You need to be thinking ahead, managing the energy of the machine. And it really puts you in sort of a meditative state. It's a great way to just calm my mind, clear my mind, you know, think about things. Don't think too much. You got to focus on riding. I also like that, you know, you are like one with the machine. I haven't found anything else like that. I'm a pilot, and never in an airplane have I ever felt the way I do on a motorcycle. When you are just, you know, your body's wrapped around this machine with so much power, and you move, it moves. It's amazing. I mean, maybe it feels like that in a fighter jet. I don't know. I've never flown a fighter jet, but this has been the best motor vehicle experience of my life, and I'm so thankful for it. So thankful to have ridden a machine that's just, you know, the top notch of what we've created, at least for consumers. So if you've never ridden a motorcycle before, consider it. You know, take the Motorcycle Safety Foundation courses, pay some money, have some classroom time, use their motorcycles. You know, no big deal if you tip one over, whatever. They'll teach you everything you need, and then you can just go apply and get your M endorsement put on your license, and then go out and buy a motorcycle and learn to ride it. I suggest getting something used, something easier to ride, because I promise you're gonna drop it or something like that. I know I did with my first bike. So, you know, if get a motorcycle. It's a great experience, but be safe. Realize it really is one of the most dangerous things to do out there. And if you're not good in the head, it'll get you, you know. And kind of like in aviation, they say there's either, you know, those who have or those that will. And when they talk about that, they're talking about accidents, you know. So I highly just suggest you get a motorcycle. Don't get one of these as your first bike. Not a good idea. But maybe not a Gixxer either, but hey, everyone's different. Eventually, you might want one of these. Check it out, the ZX14. The 2012 and newer has even more horsepower, plus some adjustable modes so you can have less power, so you can maybe get used to the bike, I guess. Also, ABS, wheelie control. I think those things are really good for the people that aren't used to so much power. So I am so glad to have taken this out for one last ride before putting up for sale. I'm really lucky that only 10 minutes away, I've got those awesome curves through the young redwood forest. The smell even when you ride is awesome. So really lucky, and I had a great time. I'm certainly gonna miss this bike. Anyway, I just wanted to make this video here as sort of a memorial to my girl here that's leaving. Otherwise, thanks for watching Jet Fuel Only channel, and we'll see you next time.